I've decided to adopt.
What?
I'm 39 years old. Nobody wants these eggs anymore. Besides, I'm sick of men controlling my life, pretending to be some kind of knight in shining armor, saving me from utter doom. I'm ready to take on something of my own, and I don't need a husband to do it.
How feminist of you.
I'm adopting because I'm ready. I have a lot of love to give, and I'm tired of waiting for it.
Have you really thought about this? This is a lot harder than raising cats. You have to pay for college, give up having a sex life.
I've thought about all that.
I'm not saying you can. I'm just checking to make sure this isn't another passing idea of yours, like rollerblading or opening a Buddhist greeting card shop.
I've never been so sure of anything else in my life. Can you help me?
With what?
You know, if I need help raising him or her, whatever we decide.
Of course I will. Don't you need to think this through?
I'm already halfway through the process. I went through an agency in Syracuse. They told me I passed the home study yesterday. I even completed the INS forms.
INS?
I'm doing an international adoption. Oh, there are thousands of couples who want babies here. They get preference. Singles are at the bottom of the list. Look, Central America, Brazil. These kids have even less of a chance. The responsibility is all mine. You don't have to do anything you don't want. I'm just saying, just in case he, she needs a father, you'll pitch in, won't you?
This is so sudden. What is the word father? Give me the heebie-jeebies.
You love kids. You always said you thought about having a kid of your own. This will be like a trial run.
I thought about it. I don't know if I'm ready yet.
When is ready for you? You waited until you were 30 before you told mom and dad you were gay, and by that time you were already passing out condoms on the streets of Buffalo. Besides, it'll really just be mine. I just need you to help me.
With mom and dad?
Defend me against them? They already think I'm a hopeless flake. They'll trust you if you think it's a good idea. Somehow you're in on it with me.
You can do whatever you want, Katie. You're almost 40.
Don't say the F word. And you know that isn't true. Yeah, I can do whatever I want, but then they'll curse me for the rest of my life with a Sicilian evil eye. The last time I went to Dad with news was right after I had my first divorce.
Oh, don't start
that. You know what he said.
Yes.
He looked me right in the eye and he said, You'll go to hell. I will never forget the sound of his voice.
He didn't mean it. No. You know it. They got older and wiser.
No, they just lost the ability to fight back. I never bothered telling him about the other two divorces after that.
I think he figured it out.
It was completely different for you. Even when you told them you were gay, it was like nothing.
Oh, now you're exaggerating.
I was the guinea pig. By the time they got to you, they just pooped out.
They love you too, Katie. Mm. They always ask about you. They're afraid to talk to you. You burst into flames the moment they say the wrong thing. Look, maybe you should think about this some more.
It's too late. I'm already committed.
What if the child were sick? I read about a couple that adopted a baby girl in China. They didn't find out she had hepatitis B until they got back to the States. They don't even run those kinds of tests
there. It's a chance I'll have to take. Are you in this with me or not?
Maybe you could go to a sperm bank. I just think you should consider all your options.
Oh, you are just like mom and dad, always questioning me. I thought I could count on you.
You ever think maybe you're doing all this just to get back at mom and dad?
What? This whole adoption process isn't easy, David. If I was really doing this for selfish reasons, I could just replicate these fabulous genes by having a one-night stand with some idiot dweeb at the bank. I'm going through with this, whether you're behind me or not.
Katie!